Liberty is power, not power over a country or other people of any kind, but power over yourself. Liberty is the power to make your own choices, to decide for yourself every action that you undertake. You make the choices and you are in control. That doesn't necessarily mean that everyone else will agree with or respect those choices that you have the freedom to make, and in some cases there might even be some consequences. Although this is true, it doesn't alter the fact that the power to make decisions is in your hands and always will be. The freedom to choose the action you will take is complete and unconditional. Unless one is physically unable to proceed with an action, nothing but one's conscience is keeping him or her from carrying through with it. The only thing that can stop you from being independent is yourself. Liberty is that freedom and control over yourself and what you choose to do. There are many different types of freedoms in America. You are free to choose to travel on an airplane or in a car. You have the liberty to make a phone call and can choose to write a letter instead. On these small decisions or bigger choices as well, liberty is power and freedom and independence. Liberty, freedom, and independence, these are core ideas that America was built off of. In the life of a high school student like myself, there may not seem to be, but there are many examples of liberty even in our daily lives. Having the power to make choices and take action is an extremely wonderful thing, but this power most of the time will not pass unchallenged. For every action you take, for every deed that is done, there is always and unfailingly a consequence. Whether these consequences come from the law or simply from people in your life, whether it's positive or negative, they are inevitable and unavoidable. Let's see. Consequences, yes, but the choices we make are ours to make. Liberty is freedom, and in America, freedom is abundant. Everywhere we turn, there are examples of everyday liberties scattered within our lives. To name them all would be impossible. And having those freedoms, independence, and control over oneself is something many of us take for granted. But in reality, it is special and it is a gift. What Lady Liberty symbolizes is the philosophy of the United States and how special and privileged all of her citizens are. Lady Liberty symbolizes the gift of freedom and the individual power it grants us. Just a short sample of one of the essays.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Yeah, yeah. These truly are from high school students, and good stuff, man, good stuff. I agree.
Truly motivational, coming from a younger generation. Especially, technically, this is the next generation coming up.
Absolutely.
And it is truly empowering to hear that they've been listening. That they know the right from the wrong, and that they're expressing freedom like they are just in those few short statements that you're that.
Yeah, in spite of and a lot of these kids are from private schools from K through the grades 8, and in many regards, like the Catholic schools and religious based schools and whatever the case might be, they have a lot more freedom. Kind of give both sides of the equation, if you will,
yes,
as opposed to slanting one way or the other. And I think that's important. These kids, many of them are getting it and get the fact that, what it is to be an American and what we're based on and the whole nine yards, man. It's, I have many kids quoting the Declaration of Independence, quoting different historical documents throughout our history that talk to and speak to what we're all about in this country, and it's great stuff, man. It really pumps me up.
Well, Godfather, the teacher has done his job for the day. Are you ready to dismiss class?
Yes, indeed, Pumpkin. It is always a pleasure to be with you here on The Teacher and the
Creature.
Yes, indeed.
Oops, sorry. No, I was trying to get this song in the bumper here for you, but
yeah, there's a great song coming up. It's by Emily Sandy. It's called Read All About It. Listen to the lyrics of this song coming up. It really speaks to what we were talking about today. And always a pleasure being with you, my friend. And I look forward to next Monday as well. And don't forget to get out and vote tomorrow, everybody. But bone up on the issues and the candidates. And just don't go in there blindly and just circle a name just because, they happen to have a certain letter in front of that name. Judge people by not just the color of their skin or what they're espousing, but the real content of their character, man. That's what we should be voting on people on.
Oh, definitely. I 100% agree with you. I want to say thank you, AA Ron, RD, Mandy Pinetown, of course, Phoenix Kiss listening in from, you know, between classes and stuff, driving into school today.
Yes, yes, indeed. And all those folks out there who access the archives, thank you very much for listening in. And we'll see you again next Monday, Pumpkin.
Hey, thank you very much, Godfather. It's always a pleasure. And as always, let you know, can we get dismissed, please? I mean,
yes, 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 indeed. Class is dismissed. Don't forget your homework assignment for next week. We'll be talking about the results of the elections, I'm sure, at some point in time.
Yes,
coming
yes.
up next Monday. And again, you know, look forward to tonight on Night Talk, our brother station over there, Night Talk with Mr. Jay Sands in the big chair tonight over on the SandsNet Radio Network. Jay's on Monday and Thursday. Rick's on Tuesday, Wednesday, and of course Pumpkin and Rick do Night Talk, the weekend edition, every Friday and Saturday at 10 p.m. And don't forget to check out Pumpkin Face's great platform, The Truth Porn Militia, with his Friday, First Amendment Friday, Second Amendment Saturday, and his Sunday School for Patriots, along with many other great shows over there on that platform. And again,
you know, it's funny though, because Jay showed up last Monday and I lost a boatload of money on him. So this week the polls have changed. Now it's 60% think he won't show up, 40% think he will show up. And he gained 20% favor, but I'm actually betting against him showing up again tonight. So
the Ouija poll, it says 100% without a doubt the Sandman will be in the big chair tonight, the night before the election.
Really, you think?
Oh, absolutely.
But I've already placed my bet saying that he's not showing up. That come on, man! Don't tell me I've got the odds against me now.
Yeah, he'll be back to his first life. Forget the second life tonight.
Yeah.
He'll be back to.
All right. Enough shine in your apple. I'll let's goodbye, everybody.
Yeah, take care, everybody.